In this week's court report, an area man arrested three times in recent months for burglary-related crimes appears in district court while in custody for his arraignment hearing. However, Christopher J. Ream's arraignment was continued. Ream is currently facing two formal charges of grand larceny at the higher court level. During the defendant's district court appearance, Ream was present while in custody with his attorney, Jason Ernest. During that proceeding, it was noted that a guilty plea agreement was submitted to the court. The court calls the matter an arraignment hearing. The defendant waived formal reading of the information, and the court began to canvass the defendant, but found that Ream was too upset to continue court proceedings due to a family issue. Attorney Ernest made an oral motion for an OR release, but the DA objected and outlined Ream's criminal history. The court subsequently denied that OR release, so Attorney Ernest then requested bail, but the DA requested $10,000 bail. The court set that bail amount and adds that if Ream is bailed out, he's ordered to report to drug court. Those matters were then continued. The Pahrump woman charged with luring a child and indecent or obscene exposure after attempting to lure children into her vehicle at Ian Dorch Park, then exposing her breast, is sentenced in district court on those charges. Shauna Lee Gibbons was present at liberty for her sentencing, during which the court noted that the defendant tested positive that day for an unspecified substance, but then will submit a test to the lab to confirm what that substance is due to her other medical issues, and then proceeded with sentencing. The court outlined that case history and reviewed the sentencing recommendations of the Division of Parole and Probation. Gibbons' attorney, David Reichert, addressed the court and outlined the defendant's mental issue, then requested drop-down and probation. The DA concurs with the PSI report. Gibbons then addressed the court herself and apologized for her actions, outlined her medical treatment, and requested probation. Regarding formal sentencing, the court ordered the defendant to pay a total of $28 in fees and $16.06 in restitution to NCSD due within 90 days. The court also ordered 364 days credit time served in NCSD, sentence suspended, 3 years probation, all the standard fines and fees set for the defendant in the PSI report, and the court outlines the terms and conditions of probation, 274 days credit for time served. Notably, Gibbons was rearrested back on September 25th, 2017 on home invasion charges after she racked up those child obscenity charges. This has been your court report. I'm Eunette Gentry for News 46.